Presentar al doctor Nelson Lima, quien es biólogo de profesión y doctor en ciencias de la ingeniería con mención en biotecnología. Es profesor titular de la Universidad de Miño en Braga, Portugal, en el área de la educación ambiental. Su área de investigación está relacionada con la seguridad e inocuidad alimentaria, principalmente micotoxinas en alimentos, así como en micología ambiental, biotecnología y preservación de recursos microbiológicos. Desde 1996 es responsable de la colección de cultivos portuguesa de la Micoteca de la Universidad de Miño, por sus siglas en portugués, MUM. Ha sido evaluador y consultor de diversas agencias de financiación de Europa y América Latina, colaborando en varios proyectos de investigación financiados por agencias europeas y brasileñas, así como investigador responsable y co-investigador en varios proyectos de investigación, tanto portugueses como europeos. Actualmente es coordinador del proyecto europeo MIRRI 21, Implementation and Sustainability of Microbial Resource Research Infrastructure for the 21st Century, Implementación y Sustentabilidad en la Infraestructura de Investigación del Recurso Microbiano para el Siglo XXI. Participa también en los proyectos europeos ISIDOR, Integrated Services for Infectious Disease Outbreak Research, Servicios Integrados para la Investigación de Brotes de Enfermedades Infecciosas, así como para el CAN Service, Providing Cutting Edge Cancer Research Services Across Europe. Servicios para proporcionar investigación de vanguardia en cáncer en toda Europa. Fue presidente de la Organización Europea de Colecciones de Cultivos, sus siglas ECO, de 2013 a 2019, y representante de esta ECO en la Comisión de Recursos Genéticos de la Organización de las Naciones Unidas para la Alimentación y la Agricultura, FAO. Fue profesor guía de más de 50 tesis en posgrado y más de 30 proyectos de postdoctorado. En los últimos cinco años ha publicado más de 60 artículos indizados en el sistema EasyWOS Scopus. Y en el año 2016 recibió el título de profesor honoris causa de la Universidad Federal de Pernambuco en Recife, Brasil. Y en su honor, debido a las aportaciones en el campo de micología, se asoció su nombre con la nueva especie brasileña Penicillium Lime. Welcome. Tom, Dr. Lima, aprovecho para decirles, la plática va a ser en inglés. Las preguntas las pueden poner en el chat, se las podemos traducir a él si nos da tiempo, y si no, también pedirle que las conteste en el chat. Welcome, and a pleasure to meet you, and I give you the microphone. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon, everyone. I hope to to share the screen and also to expand my slides. It's a good pleasure for me to contribute today to discuss and to present this research infrastructure related with the microbial resource at European level. Sorry, I will speak in English, but you can put your question in Spanish and I can answer also in Spanish. It's not a problem, but to make my life easier, I will speak and I will present in English. So let me start about the new project that is the implementation and sustainability of microbial resourcing research infrastructure. That is a EU project, the European Union project funding, and it start on the February 2020 and it will finish next January. Nevertheless, we are now discussing the extension of this project for more 6 months, since for that when we started we start this project with also the pandemic problems around the world. So it was quite complex for us. This project is related with and to support the research, development, and innovation of preserve the microbial life and how the microbial life and the microorganisms can apply to the scientific research. For this, we have with us now 13 partners because we start with 14. Unfortunately, we lost the Russian Federation for the reasons that all you know. And now we are 13 partners, and my university is the coordinator. This project search mainly that we can supply in our microbial collections around Europe a broad range of different microorganisms, but with high quality standards, with associated with the related data. And again, the data with high quality. Here, the quality is a key element, since we know that the basic research of the clinical and different fields of the research that use microorganisms as well as the industry and service that use microorganisms, only they are able to do good research with high quality research and use the microorganisms to produce add-value products in the industry or service. Only they need to have the raw materials with high quality. So we need also to have a long-term sustainability to preserve the microbial diversity in the collections, and also to have better knowledge about microbial biodiversity and professional development. So the project is developed mainly in different work packages. The number one is related with the project management. The number two is related with the research strategy. Number three, central governance and operations. Number four, related to the transnational access pilot. And I will speak later on more about these. Number six, capacity building, training and education. Number six, collaborative work environment platform, that is our platform. The work package seven, outreach and dissemination. Number eight, consolidation and enlargement of membership of MURI. And business and research infrastructure sustainability, number nine. And the last one, last but not least, the ethical requirements. All these is related to try to work our collaborative work environment, that is our platform for the MURI, to establish an important program at the European level, but abroad, that is transnational access. I will tell you more about this, education and training, and of course, MURI membership. And why? Because so far our collections at European level, but it's not a problem only at European level, but it's global, we have a blurry current situation because the users want to get service, we want to get microorganism data related with microorganisms, resource training, expertise, so access to our information, but they all these are fragments. So and this means that all these resources and the expertise that we have in microbial culture collection are suboptimal exploits at the European level and abroad. So to change this and to meet the needs of our user communities, we developed the concept of MURI. And MURI is a microbial research infrastructure that is pan-distribute European research infrastructure to preserve and to make research provisions and valorization of microbial resource and biodiversity. and why to avoid the fragmentation that we are living now, to put and bring all the collections and the services under a coordinated service and offer to the communities, the user communities, a better service and better quality, a reference material with high quality control and reference materials and data associated. For this, MIURI is organized as a consortium that it was put on the strategic report on research infrastructure at the European level. We started 10 years ago working on this. Now we are a landmark, and last June we became also a legal entity. Now we are a legal entity at recognized at the European level with autonomy to develop our strategy. MIURI is one of the MIURI is one of the research infrastructures on this roadmap. It's here and is connected with health and food sector. So the health and food sector has different research infrastructures relate with the different areas of the research and provide different services, but we are all interconnected. MIURI is related with microorganisms, but ERINA is also related with microorganisms, but high pathogenic microorganisms. For instance, in contracts, we have the European Open Screen that screen bioactive molecules. All infrastructure related with bioimaging is bioimaging infrastructure. And the BBMRI is related is also related with biological resource, but human derivative biological resource. That means that is the human part of the resource. So we have here a clear ecosystem that we work all together to provide better service and to speed up the research and the innovation at European level and beyond of Europe, because we are now working in emerging areas like synthetic biology, future therapies, infectious threats and their impact, biomedical engineering and electronics, biotechnologies, intra-domains and cross-sectorial clusters to filling existing gaps, research infrastructure for assessment and management, human health and environmental medicine and personalized medicines, link dietary behavior to both food, health and environmental impact, data and artificial intelligence. And in the food needs, we more use reducing the green gas emission and the ecosystems, especially in agriculture, sustainability and ecosystem function, energy and climate smart food system, and ecosystem carbon storage, and a more resilient and personalized agriculture. So the MIURI composition now is, we have five members as countries that are on the pink, and more five countries that are looking to and approach us to be member, are prospective members. Because the members of this structure, research infrastructure, are countries. In Portugal, we have a network of the collections. We work for many years as a network, and it's the reason that in Portugal, in my university, we have the headquarters of this research infrastructure, and all of you are welcome to visit us and to work with us also. Who is our members? Our members are countries, as I said. We have now five members, full members. We are now working with other countries, European countries, but we are also working with Brazil and Chile to be members. And we also are open to other countries and other organizations. So this brings all together a long experience, more than 50 collections that we have a solid experience. We work together and we work with microorganisms. We totally combine in a number of years of this collection, more than 2,800 years of expertise. We have also multiple different experts among us, some of them top scientists that they are more than 100 each index in their curriculum, and the different colors tell you the different domains that are where they have their expertise: health and food, agro-food, environmental energy, but any other topics like legal issues, bioinformatics, biobanks, taxonomy or microbial taxonomy, and so on. So far in terms of big key figures, we are 10 countries, 5 members and 5 prospective members, more than 50 organizations. We have a long combined years and a good expertise accumulated. More than 2/3 organizations have a quality management system implemented or in implementation. We have 7 strategic scientific areas. We have more than 300 people work together. We have top scientists with us. We have more than 400,000 microbial resources available in one single catalog. We distribute and we characterize more than 20,000 strains per year to the service industry and for academia. We provide more than 60 types of service. Some of them combine service in workflow, more than 30. We have all more than 6,000 users per year. And we have a lot of people that follow us in social media and our activity. How we work? We have a top decision board that is the assembly of members with advisory board and ethical board. The assembly of members are a representative of each country, of the funding agencies, of the Ministry of Science and Technology. At my university, at the headquarters, we have what we call the Center Coordinate Unit. We have the executive director and other officers, centralized all the work of this distribute national notes at different countries with coordinated the different collections. We have one platform that is our single access point. This is the executive level and this is the operative level. At the executive level, we have the executive director, that is Luis, that we have the secretary, it's Ana, financial manager, access officer, that is sit in Portugal, and IT officer is sit in Spain, since we have a collaboration with the University of Valencia to work together. I with Armando, we coordinate also the project that funding all this structure. So in our research infrastructure, we have an agenda, a strategic research and innovation agenda for a green, healthy, and sustainable future. We can download these from our web page. And they are 7 strategic areas organized in healthy and food, agro-food, environment, and energy. We are based in our expertise in bioprospecting, preservation and cultural mix of microbial taxonomy, digital service, fair data, legal, regulatory issues and standards. And our inputs is boost the biodiversity, the biotechnology, the bioeconomy, sustainability and one health, and of course, the biocircular economy that is also quite important for us. I don't go in details strategic area by strategic areas, but I want to tell you that all strategic areas are aligned with the different strategic develop, the sustainable development goal of the United Nations, with aligned with the different horizon Europe cluster and Europe missions, and of course the different partnerships that we have at the European level. And we work, as I told you, as a, in a cluster or in an ecosystem with other research infrastructure. In this first area that is related with the research on pathogenic microorganisms for and human animal infection disease, we submit two projects at European level and both related with COVID, and both were approved. We have also the research and develop of new pharmaceutical, new and innovative therapeutic solutions, and here the cancer that it was during my introduction, it was also mentioned, the cancer service. We have also, and it was approved, we have also activities related with food and health and sustainable food and feed products, and also relate with the management of soils and crops. The agricultural and the AgroServe project, it was also approved in terms of more personalized agriculture in at European level. Again, you can see the different sustainable development goals that we are trying to achieve with this approach. We have other areas like biomonitoring, bioremediation of microbial pathogens and relate with organic pollution. We have the, also a lot of activities on renewable bio-based chemicals, materials and bioenergy sources. Finally, of course, the rescue and preserve microbial diversity, that is one of the, our main core as activities. I can show you this infographic that we have in our webpage, but this infographic show you the seven strategic areas, but one of the key points that all cover eight of out of the 17 United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, that is important for also. What does MIRI offer? We offer a domain, a different domains of interest that I list before relate with our strategic areas, of course, linked to the environment management, agriculture, human, animal, and plant health, like the concept of one health, Antarctic strands, food industry, cosmetics, biofuels, bioremediation, aquaculture, industrial biocatalysts, bioeconomy, and circular economy, probiotics, vine production, biopesticides, and the bio insect seeds, and bio other bioactive compounds to replace agrotoxic compounds, and wastewater treatment. Our expertise follow in different areas that I mentioned before, mainly biotechnology, food industry, mainly plant pathology, clinical microbiology, molecular biology, food microbiology. All expertise are able to make service, and our service are depositing molecular identification, next generation sequence, screening tests, and of course, integrated service in health and food, diagnostic, biopharmaceutic, microbial-based therapeutics, and health promoting solution, agro-food, food production, food safety and agriculture, and in environmental energy, of course, bioremediation and bioenergy production and biodiesel production. Why offer service and open our laboratories to all that want to join us, because we have also cutting edge technology that go to the isolation of microorganisms in bioprospecting and we can isolate, we can identify and characterize, you can preserve the bioresource and the data, and then we can supply for different domains, for different applications, add value in this chain from the microorganisms that comes from different substrates until to the different applications. And using the different technologies and expertise to develop this technology. I don't go in detail to this technology, but it's very important to understand that our work is based in service, and we are user centers. And for this, we have one platform that is www.mirid.org, and we have expert clusters that can organize and answer to your questions. We have a single catalog of microorganisms all merged, and all information is merged. We have a different service and like TNA programs, I will speak later on, and we have training and education specific. What this means, these transnational access programs? This means that when we call, we open a call, we open a call to open our laboratories, our service, and our products to a project, to different people, different areas, different countries, not only at the European level, but abroad, that can apply if they have a project applied and the international panel assessed positively, we provide the products, or we facilitate the access, giving a grant, paid the travel and the accommodation, and we open the laboratory to the team or to the research or the applicants to make the research that we want to do. The point here is we are open to this. We pay to the research camp, to our laboratory, to speed the process and take the advantage of our expertise. At the end of the day, the data and the results belongs to the applicant, the researcher, not to the MIRI. Only it is compulsory to acknowledge if they publish or when they use this data and these results. We are will not be never co-authors or whatever. The results are from the person that gained the project and use the results as they want. All they need to acknowledge that they have a grant to come to Europe, to our laboratories and our facilities. We have so far 14 facilities across the Europe that we can offer a funding access to the microbial resources, the facilities, the laboratories, and the equipment. So please be aware about these calls because you can apply. And we can apply using different microorganisms, different groups, and different fields related with our strategic areas. So we need to have this match, and of course, we can use also our expert clusters, our training that we provide. So be aware about this, because MIRI is open to offer this access and pay also to you to come to Europe if your project is attractive, innovative, and fits with our offer. Finally, to show what we are doing, of course, that we are a strong research infrastructure, as a legal infrastructure, and we are partner now of different projects. Now, this year, we applied for 6 projects at the European level. We gained the 6 projects. You can see that some projects like BioCOVID and Isidore are related to COVID with a lot of different partners and big money. This one is related with the cancer. This AgroServe, I told you and I speak about this before, but these are now the two new ones, that is microbe that is related with microbiome biobank enable. That is under negotiation, but it will be funding about 6 millions of euros. And the industry 4.0, the new industry concept, and this is under negotiation, is about 10 millions also. All these projects also will provide to you service and TNA grants if you want to join us to have to develop a good idea or a good project. You can provide, you can also look to these projects and to the calls, and you can also come to Europe and to our facilities to develop your ideas. So this show you how we are working at the European level, how important microorganisms are nowadays, not only as a reference material, but the materials to use for different applications, who you are working at as an ecosystem using different research infrastructure that we can combine, and you are able to also to open all these to the research, mainly for European level, but about 20% is open to foreign or non-European countries that can apply also and take advantage of this. So, sorry, this is also important because is the 17 development, sustainable development goal, that is the partnership. And don't forget that we are foster more and more the partnership, and we are quite happy to see you in our laboratories. This give you the final idea why you can join us or you work with us. The advantage is to make more competitive, to speed the research, to take advantage of our microbiome resource and our expertise, the standardization data, the associated to the microbiome resource, and also to increase the accessibility to our capacities, take advantage of high profile conferred by the MIRI brand. So this is my last slide. I wish to thank you so much to have this opportunity to speak about MIRI to this Congress, and thank you to the organizers to invite me and MIRI to tell you what we are doing in the microbiome domain with the microorganism, but also what we can offer to you related to our service. So please don't forget to follow us in our social media and visit our webpage. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Lima. And I will ask you one question. Let me see. Preguntan aquí, ¿qué diferencia hay entre esta colección y la del CDC? ¿Y si hay colaboración con Estados Unidos?
Yes. The major point is the CDC is one single collection controlled by CDC. Of course, they have internal different collections, but is controlled by one organization. Here, what we have is not one, is a top level organization, because it's a top level that combine different organizations like Institute Pasteur in RA in France or in Portugal or in Spain, in different countries. So that means that we are a multi different countries that we are working, harmonizing, and put all together. So it's a top layer on this. First point. Second point, yes, we are working, and we are now in a phase to write a memorandum of understanding with the USCCN. That means United States Culture Collection Network. And also we are now speaking and also address with CDC to work in some parts of the clinical field. Yes, of course, we are. We have strong connections because the United States and is it will never be a partner because it's independent, but the National Science Foundation and the network of culture collections from the United States, we are starting working under a memorandum of understanding to have some harmonized procedures and some collaborative studies. Yes.
Thank you very much. I will ask you another question. ¿Cómo evitamos que MIRI sea usado para la producción de armas biológicas?
Oh, yes, a very good question. Of course, that MIRI has put in place and the European collections, they have put in place a set of controls when we provide the microorganisms. First, mainly our MIRI, the microorganisms are up to risk level two. That means that the few are classified as risk three, and the high pathogenic microorganisms are not with us. I told that is ARINA, that is another research infrastructure, only to treat with high pathogenic microorganisms. Nevertheless, all you know that our risk two could be converted in a bioweapon. This is another control that we do, that is only we provide microorganisms to organizations that we know, and they show us that they have the capabilities to work with them, and they have put in place standards to control this. At the same time, we have a very tight collaboration with our officers, different offices, internal controls and at the European level to control the facilities, the access of these microorganisms. But this is, of course, a key issue related with biosecurity as well as biosafety.
Thank you very much. And I will ask you a last question. Right, let me see. How can I contact you to collaborate with the Mexican Society? Who can I contact to collaborate with the Mexican Society? Preguntan que sí.
Yes, of course. Of course, that you can contact by email, but if you go to the web page, of course, that we have the access officer and the communication, the access officer email, because we have all platform is one single site. So we have the central, we are a distribute organization, but I coordinate. As a coordination unit, all information that comes in from one email, that is the access email that is available on the web page, or you can find my email and contact me directly. Is up to you. But normally, if you go through the web page, we can contact with the emails that we have there. Because we have, as I told you, the Central Coordinate Unit coordinate all the activities that we have in different countries, because each countries and the different organizations that they have their own organization is a distributed infrastructure, highly coordinated. And we coordinate all this access and the information also.
Thank you very much, Dr. Lina.